Today's question in the question and answer series for Research Like a Pro is how to export a table in Airtable to a CSV file. This question came up in our study group, and it says, I would like to be able to get AI bots to help in analyzing my timeline for future location and research. How do I download and save the information out of Airtable so I can upload it to the AI? So this is a great question, and there's multiple reasons why we might want to do this. This is a good reason to use the chatbot to analyze your timeline, but also if we want to back up our Airtable base at the end of a project or just anytime we're done working on it so that we don't lose any information and to keep our information from getting lost. Here is my Airtable base that I've been working on this year, and you can see an arrow pointing to the title of the view that we're looking at. So we're in the timeline table, and I have multiple different views. If you don't have multiple views that you've renamed, then you might see like a generic name here, like grid view. But if you have multiple views and if you've renamed the view to be something other than grid view, then it will say whatever you've named it. So this view is a timeline of just John Robert Dyer. So any records that he's mentioned on, he's going to be in this view of the timeline. So this little drop down here is how you're going to save this as a CSV file. So one thing that's important to note about this is that if you're not in the full view of your timeline, if you're just looking at a portion of it, this filtered view of only John Robert Dyer's records, then when you export the CSV, you're only going to see what you're currently seeing in this view. So before you export your timeline, make sure you're in the full view that has everything, and you can switch views here. But if this is what you want to export, then you're ready to go. So clicking this arrow down, this drop down next to the name of the view, will open up this menu and give you the option to download the CSV. Once you click this button, then you'll see a file open up on your computer and it will prompt you for where you want to save the CSV file. And CSV stands for comma separated values. So it's table data that you can open with a spreadsheet program. And so let's say you want to open it in Excel or upload it to ChatGPT or Claude. This is a file format that those chatbots can read. Now, if you want to continue using the CSV file to analyze your timeline with a chatbot, here's an example prompt you might use. And the one that I used was Claude.ai. You are an expert genealogist. Review this attached timeline for John Robert Dyer. So, to attach a timeline to Claude, you just click the paperclip and you upload the file. You could also copy and paste the table data, but I find that uploading a CSV file works fine. Then the next part of the prompt says, suggest what I might study in my locality research of relevant places and extant records to augment the current research. Also, suggest avenues for studying historical and social context to better understand the research subject. So, this is what it looks like in Claude. So, I uploaded the timeline and put in the prompt I just read. And then it says, after reviewing the timeline, I can suggest several avenues of for locality research and historical context that could augment your current research. And then it gives us this artifact, and you can click to open it, and it opens in the sidebar. And then it gives us the suggestions. Locality research suggestions was first, and it gives some information about how to research more records in Hawkins County, Tennessee, where the research subject lived, land, court, probate, and marriage records. And then it gives us some more information for Greene County, Tennessee, trying to understand why one of John Robert Dyer's sons got married there, North Carolina records, which is maybe where he was born, church records, specifically churches near Terrapin Valley, where John Robert Dyer lived, military records, perhaps for Civil War for his sons, and then newspaper records. So those were kind of generic overviews, but can be helpful. Then the next part, as I scroll down in the document, as you can see, there's a scroll bar over here. It has historical and social context research, so some different suggestions for that. So it's using the timeline that I already have and building on that and giving some suggestions. So agricultural practices, study the typical farming methods and crops in Hawkins County to study his life as a farmer, economic conditions, Civil War impact, health and medicine, migration patterns, social structures, legal system, and education. So this was an interesting kind of analysis of my timeline with ideas. So this could help with the future of research planning, and it could also give us ideas for locality research, like what I need to learn more about. Like, do I need to find out, are there any more agricultural type of sources I could look at? I have one of the agricultural censuses. Are there others I could get? Maybe I could look into that during locality research to see what agricultural censuses are extant. So thank you for submitting that question, and I hope that helps to learn about how you can export your Airtable base and then analyze it with a chatbot. One final suggestion, I'm going to go back here, is if you end up having a problem with your Airtable base and maybe you delete something or a whole table gets deleted, which actually did happen this week to someone, if that happens to you, just know that there's this little history button here. And if you click on this little arrow with the time inside of it, you can see your snapshots. And a snapshot history is kept for your Airtable base for 2 weeks on the free plan. And if you made a mistake and something is gone and you need to go back to an earlier version, you can restore a snapshot of your base and get back what you lost. So just know that this is here and take a look at it and check it out. All right, thanks for watching.